Hey everybody, what's up? Thank you for joining me. In this reaction video, we're going to be listening to that new Judas Priest single, Trial by Fire, from their new album, Invincible Shield, which should be out sometime next spring. And we're also going to listen to Strike of the Viper from KK's Priest off the album The Sinner Rides Again that came out this last September 2023. And what's really cool is somebody had suggested the Strike of the Viper track from the last YouTube video I did of Panic Attack against One More Shot of Glory. And that's really cool that somebody had offered a suggestion, and I really appreciate it. So we're going to listen to those two tracks and see which one comes out on top. There was really split last time. A lot of people said that the Priest track was better than the KK Priest track, but I find that each had their strengths, and there may be some weaknesses in each song as well. But overall, the bottom line is we got two really good songs from two different bands that obviously sound somewhat similar with two great vocalists. I mean, how could we lose? So this whole versus thing is just more kind of like personal preference and, you know, whatever you like. So it's all subjective. But at any rate, let's hear that new Judas Priest single, Trial by Fire, from Invincible Shield. Let's check it out. All right, here we go. Trial by Fire. Cool fading intro. I got the feeling this one's not going to be as high energy, but I could be wrong. That looks familiar. Isn't Trial by Fire a Testament tune as well? Rob Halford on the vocals, of course. Glenn Tipton on the studio guitars. Richie Faulkner guitar. Ian Hill, the not original member. Scott Travis on the drums, Mr. Eraser X. Cool guitar melody going on. Kind of has a melodic death metal vibe to it. It's kind of more progressive, really, with the way the feel of the song is. Production's really good on this album. Andy Sneap once again. Diminished stuff. Definitely less energy in this track. There you have it. Trial by Fire, Judas Priest, Invincible Shield. Is it just me or does that shield look like something from The Legend of Zelda? I mean, it's cartoon looking and everything like that, but it's cool. This track really didn't strike a chord with me. I mean, it's got some really cool hooks in it. I can get the vocal cadence and the guitar melodies are kind of cool, but it just seems like such a step backwards from Panic Attack. I mean, that song was awesome. And this one's okay too, but I honestly was expecting a little bit more, and hopefully that's the most ballad-esque thing they do on that entire record, because dynamically, it's a shift for sure. And I mean, not every song could be, you know, fast or sound the same, which is a good thing to have diversity on a record, but that seemed like it was really, really pulling it back, reining it in. But that's just my opinion. All right, so I mean, on that one, they're setting the bar not very high. Let's see what KK Priest has got. This is Strike of the Viper. Let's look at that song. Hear that one? All right. Here we go. KK Priest, Strike of the Viper. Thanks for the suggestion. I really appreciate it. All right, let's check this out. We get another music video. That's cool. High hopes on this one. That was cool. I gotta say, KK's Priest is mopping the floor with Priest on that one. I'm not gonna lie. Definitely way heavier than the Priest track. Cool, like half performance video. That's cool. Stuff cool. Ripper Owens killed it. That song was really, really short, but all songs don't need to be 5 minutes long, you know, and have 16 different guitar solos. I mean, it's really cool that they do, but, you know. Anyway, man, KK's Priest, in my opinion, had a much stronger song. You know, we'll have to wait until the entire Priest album comes out. Judas Priest Invincible Shield is released this spring, but I gotta say, you know, I wasn't impressed with Trial by Fire. I like the Testament song Trial by Fire more than the Judas Priest song Trial by Fire. I mean, you can't, not everything's going to be original name. Whatever. You know, Strike of the Viper, Strike of the Beast, you know, Isn't that like an Exodus song or something? Anyway, or is it an Anthrax song? I don't remember. But anyway, KK's Priest on that one all the way. Ripper Owens seems like he's pushing the envelope a little bit more than Halford was. The production sounds better on the KK's Priest album, too. I don't know. That could be just the medium of YouTube. You know, you don't really hear, like, the physical copy always sounds better than what you hear on the internet. But it just seems like the KK's Priest songs are sounding better. And, you know, not necessarily not just louder, but the tonal quality is better, too, in my opinion. I like the production. Not to say that Andy Steep's not, like, a master producer or engineer at all, because he's made so many great records, and I'm sure that he did a great job on the Priest album. But, yeah, I'm kind of surprised on the Judas Priest. Kind of a downer, man. Like, Panic Attack was such an ass-kicking song, and it was just, you know, in your face. And then they put out a song that's just kind of wishy-washy, and it didn't really have as much to it compositionally. You know, Panic Attack seemed to have some twists and turns. You know, it had two rounds of guitar solos. There was just more to it. I guess the difference between the One More Shot at Glory and Strike of the Viper is that One More Shot at Glory had more of an anthemic kind of vibe. The song was much longer, too. But, you know, there was a lot packed into 3 and 7 minutes in Strike of the Viper. But I'd have to say that in this round, in my opinion, subjectively, that I like the KK's Priest song better. But was it better than Panic Attack? Was Strike of the Viper better than Panic Attack? I don't think so. Do I think it was better than One More Shot at Glory? No, I don't. And I think that the reason why is because One More Shot at Glory had a sing-along chorus. It was more memorable. I think in this style of metal or subgenre of metal or heavy metal or whatever, having those sing-along choruses is huge. Yes, Trial by Fire had a chorus, but it just didn't have the intensity and the anthemic feel that, you know, One More Shot at Glory had. So I guess that's one of the reasons I think that One More Shot at Glory is just as strong a song as Panic Attack is, because the chorus in One More Shot at Glory is awesome, whereas the chorus in Panic Attack kind of left something to be desired. And I kind of see that in Trial by Fire as well, because it seemed like they didn't really like... the cadence didn't match the feel once again. I mean, it did. It hit in certain spots, but it wasn't like they were filling the entire part with vocals where there could have been. But anyway, it still sounds awesome, but not going to diss anybody. But I got to say that the KK Priest track, in my opinion, was stronger. Hopefully, we get the next Priest single soon, Judas Priest single soon. And, you know, we can do this again. I gotta say, I'm overwhelmed by the reaction that everybody had to the first Judas Priest, KK's Priest video. I really appreciate it. That's huge. It made me feel that I'm doing something right, and I appreciate everybody's interactions, everybody sharing it, everybody watching it, and I'm gonna keep cranking these videos out. If you get a chance, check out the interview that I did with Mark Koppel from Misery Index and Scour. We did that yesterday, and it's full of really cool information and some good insights from Mark, who's a, you know, a professional. And, you know, if you guys are digging the guitar videos with the tabs, let me know. All those tabs are free. So, you know, keep getting that content. I'll keep putting it out there. Please like and subscribe. It means a lot, and it keeps the ball rolling. So anyway, thank you guys very much. KK's Priest is the winner in this round. Have a good night. Later.